Hello everyone, thank you so much for joining me in this class. We will design gadgets in this class. In this course, we will design all of these parts, all of these products we will design from scratch. I will guide you through the process of making all of these gadgets in Blender 3. So let's get started. Alright, so let's begin our lesson. I will activate the screencast keys as usual, so you can check and watch everything I press. You will can cheer. We'll start from a plane, and this plane is 200 meter, and I will say it will be 50 only, and we can zoom. So this is the base. This is the base, and I will select some parts and press Ctrl Shift B to bevel like this, and add some lookup. After that, join, then join, then join, then join. I will do my best to match the reference, and why I am doing this because I don't want to have handguns. And let's extrude maybe 15, maybe 15 or 12, maybe 12, extrude another time. Just maybe 3, and the scale shift Z 0.9, right? And we can do the inset now. Scale shift Z, extrude scale shift Z. And after that, we can extrude and move in this direction, maybe to this distance. Add loop cut, and we will add loop cut here. All right. We have the base shape, and after that we can, let's try to add loop cut here and bevel this loop cut. One point six, and let's add edge loop here. and we can extrude now to and to the Z axis. I will select all these vertices and extrude in the Z minus 5, scale Z 0, and we can add loop cut here, and this will be circle. Let's add loop cut here, and in this place we will add cylinder, and this cylinder may be 30 or 20 width, and scale and move in this way. Move in the Z axis, and let's select this part and add the boolean. After that I will select this to be difference. Let's try the first. I will make the exact and we can select normal to be smooth. Let's try to fill to hide. No problem, we can select the cylinder and mirror and the y axis. What I have made, I have duplicated the cylinder for time. You can apply the modifier, and after that let us add circle. The circle may be 16 or 14. The number will be maybe 16, and let's scale. I will delete some vertex here, the half, and scale, then move extrude y, and we can add the mirror on the y-axis, fill, and we can add loop cut here, and if I enable merge and move that on the Y, and clipping of course. We have this one, and we will move into the axis and extrude on the Z. Let's and scale Z. Let me add sublime surface. And we should add here. and scale shift Z the cursor will be here and select all of that face and scale shift Z scale on X 0.98 scale on Y 0.9 and we will call it right maybe and we will add another mirror. This mirror will be around the x-axis here. And we will add another boolean. This time it will be union. Let's add it. And this will be the main. We'll select the right and move to cutter collection. Select also C2 and we will move to the cutter collection. That's fine. We have two holes here. Let's add the circle. Rotate X 90 degrees. Scale. The scale. Extrude around the Y. Select all. Or let's fill first. Add loop cut here and we will fill that shift S cursor selected or select all move in the Y and duplicate like that. That's fine, we can scale that down and select all and extrude in the x-axis. That's fine. And this one in the x-axis. Select this one and add another volume. This one will be this circle cutter. Let's hide. That's fine. And we will duplicate that in the Y axis in the time. Move to the cutter collection. We can add the bevel, let's try. We have made the main shape in this face. We can duplicate and separate by selection. I will add all of that and it's scaled on Z axis. set orient to geometry, scale on x, control shift b will add all the scale first, and the control shift b extrude on y and move on the y like that. I will make it shorter. The final thing we have here some lamp. So shift scores is selected. We will add sphere and scale 1:1, scale 1:1, or x 90 degrees and scale. Let's add boolean and that's fine, and I will duplicate that and it will be called the light. The sphere will be moved to the cutter collection. All right, and we have the light here. Let's scale down, scale maybe 0.95, and we can extrude on Y. Here is the light, and for that the same thing we have some hole, but I will add a cylinder, scale 1:1, rotate around x 90 degrees, scale down and move on the x axis. Select that another boolean, this time will be and we will add boolean from that its side. That's fine. That's clean. And here is a gadget. Of course that will be black and that will be the orange. Let me select some face here and all of these faces. We will press U and unwrap. And we have that in the UV editor. All right. What I will make now, I will apply one by one. from top to bottom. Like that. That's fine. And we can apply the unwrap now. And we should deselect that and unwrap. And we rotate 90 degrees, we can export that. Add another folder for the UVs. And we'll call it top UVs. We have two UVs. This is the top. We can export by 2K and fill OST 0.35. We will a few seconds until that will be imported. And we can. I have opened the UVs in Adobe Photoshop. This is the classic way. I will remove the UVs on the top. And this is the background. Let's say it will be white now. And we will type Adobe. We'll type here Adobe Illustrator. Let's say the font will be 90. Semi bold or regular. Let me select the and I have moved the word. Now we can move to be here. So the process is very simple. I will type some words here and I will put the logo, or we can type A and increase the font, maybe semi bold, and we will add some character spacing. That's it. But let's add here 15 and here like that. That's fine. Let me check. Select the Adobe Illustrator and move to here. Right. So I have prepared the file. We have typed some word here and I have exported as BNG. Let's come back to gender and we will say it will be plastic orange. And this orange will be this color. And it will be roughness 0.2. Let's add noise, bump, and the control T to add the noise, color to white. And in order to normal, add color ramp, let us increase that to be 100, and let's say it will be object. Let's this is a noise, and let's go for shading. And we are trying to make it so close. And replace that and replace Shift S by another texture such as the magic. Let's try the generated. Okay. I will combine that with mix RGB color to color, and we can multiply or sub it. Let's try multiply. Let's see. Alright, and scale maybe 50. That's fine. Let me add the background. I will say it will be like that, and I will move that to the background collection. A color may be white and have some roughness, some reflection. And let's add this to be light. It will be emission, and strength will be 5. Let's add here another light. This one will be 500 maybe, and 200. 100 is enough for now. And let's try to go for rendered. It's too much. And we are now so close, but for the bump map, it will be maybe 0.1. 0.05 and distance 0.5. That's fine. And for this one it will be plastic orange, but it will have the logo of course. And let's add the mix shader, add principal, image texture, add image to the base, and alpha to the factor, and use here the one import. Let's see after assign the material in the edit mode. Here we are. And this color will be black. It will be black like that. And roughness may be 0.5, 0.4. That's fine. I'll save, and this light will be rotated like that. Of course we'll add later as a light on light. And what I'm going to do now is to add some bolts here, and I will add the circle of 6. I rotate 30 and extrude scale. And select all these lines and add the circle. Select all and extrude in the Z. Let's first fill that area, select all and extrude in the Z, and select this face and extrude. Let's extrude in the Z, move in Z axis and extrude in the Z axis like that. Right, we can start doing surface. And I will bevel that. I will bevel and then we can make it circle and then make that circle and that also circle. And another circle here. Rotate around the Z. Let me check. Rotate around the Z axis like that. let me rotate. Alright, that will be a plastic, black plastic. And of course I will mirror around X and Y and choose this object. Apply the rotation. What happens here? And mean we should it should be on the Y, or we can shift this course selected, duplicate that. We have done something wrong. The bolt should be scaled like that. Point 8. This one also. Roughness 0.1. I will make it 0.3 specular and I will add scratches later. We have here a rope. Shift is cursor selected and add circle, solve that. I will add another circle and the circle here will be maybe 30 and scale rotate around x 90 degrees and scale. I will extrude 0.7 and then extrude and y like that. After that I will add another circle, the same circle here. This time will be 60. Put it x 90 degrees. And extrude in y. And let me check. And extrude scale like that. Scale shift y 0.9. That's fine. Select all and select checker, deselect, extrude. We will extrude scale shift y 1.1. اكسترود واي اند اكسترود سكيل اند اكسترود واي and we are moving that to the ground and extrude and while exit That will also will be plastic. Let us check the materials. This one also will be black plastic. Let's also move to the background. And I will add an HDRI. Right, so I have duplicated the first collection 3 times and I have changing the logo in Photoshop. We have to have another logo. And of course, you can simply type this in Photoshop and add a texture as we have made that. We can increase that. And this one also. And what about the render setting? I will say it will be 1200. I will increase that. And performance 256. What next? Say it will be 2000 and what is it will be the rendered view and we can now render the image. And that was the rendered the plastic can be changed and here is the final render image. So thanks a lot for watching this lesson and I hope you like it and enjoy the information included in this tutorial. See you in another course in my YouTube channel. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. So see you in the next tutorial.